gentlemen to go ahead.
All of a sudden, there with this one performance, you saw the explosion, and there were so many pyrotechnics and things that have been used in shows before. You thought, well, is that part of the show?
700 WLW aviation expert Jay Ratliff witnessed the crash. He told me as emergency crews rushed to the scene, everyone realized something had gone wrong.
This was a high performance by a pilot that had been at more shows than I can count. They did have to cut the aviator out of his craft and did everything they could to try to save his life. And unfortunately, they were unable to do so. It's going to take time for them to investigate it, and it'll be several months before they've got an idea if it was a mechanical situation or if it was a case of pilot error that led to the tragic event.
Spectators were at a distance, never in any danger.
So the spectators were miles away from it, and that's one of the safety features with all the air shows in the United States, is that if there is an accident, it's going to take place where you don't have the performers performing over the tops of the crowd. The fire officials that I spoke with said it wasn't necessarily the impact that caused the problem. It was the fact that the aircraft was fully engulfed in fire when they arrived barely a minute later. On the scene that apparently was the thing that ended up killing the aviator.